Simon Reish Vav, Dine Hefsek Vitos Verchas Appears of Vav Sifim. Beirach and Peters Ion Beirpe Adama Yat. If you made a Hadama and something was supposed to have a Hates, you were Yotze by the Evid. Avalim Beirach and Prihadama Beirpe Yotze Lo Yotze. If you said a Hates instead of a Hadama, you were not Yotze. Hyunkach. Em whom is Sopik Bepri Imu Priho Hates and Prihadama. If he has a Sufik. And again, he tried to be Mevar, they asked the Chacham and they still can't figure it out. Em who Priho Hates and Prihadama, Verch Prihadama. If he said a shakol in any food, he would be yotze v'afil al pas v'yayin, even if it was on bread or wine. Of course, this one b'di'evid, or if he truly cannot figure out the correct bracha. Hayu lefanav pri ha'adama u'fri ha'etz. If he has both a vegetable and a fruit in front of him, uvirich al pri ha'adama, and he said b'ri pri ha'adama, v'niskavin lifter es pri ha'etz, but his kavana was that his ha'adama should also cover the fruit, yotze. There are poskim who argue on this and say that he would not be yotze in this case. Lechatchila certainly should not have kavana like this. Kol engel habrachis tzarech shelo yafsik bin bracha lechila. Any bracha, all the brachas rishonos we talked about now, you cannot make a hefsik between eating, saying the bracha and eating the food. Haga yoyser mikdei dibur. An ashira hefsik here is tech dei dibur of three words, say shalom lachar rabbi. So right away he has to eat. This is lechatchila. If he didn't talk or do something else in between, he wouldn't have to repeat it. We'll talk here a number of details about how he should position himself and prepare himself to eat right away after the bracha. V'tzarech lahashmir l'oznav. He has to be able to hear himself say the bracha v'imlehishmir l'oznav yotza. If he didn't, he wasn't able to hear the bracha, he was yotze v'vatshe yotze b'sfas, as long as he pronounces the bracha with his lips. V'nemonah b'cholosh, he can say the bracha in any language. He cannot make the bracha unclothed ad shichas erva, so until he covers his erva. The men of our memory be ish of all ish yishiva sufanesha matatuchas bekarka ki bezem iskas ervasa. This would be true for a man. A woman could sit in such a way that she would cover herself. We had these halachas by kriyashim and the same halachas over here by brachas. How much he has to be covered to say a bracha. Vafim we may know Adam. Even if he is not unclothed, im liber reyes ha'erva yisharesh, imgulas nevarech, if either his heart is reyes ha'erva, there was no hefsek between his heart and his erva, is all under one cloth without a belt, or his head is uncovered, he cannot make a bracha. So many times that by us, we always have to have our heads covered. That's a minag. Anything that you're going to say a bracha on to eat it or to smell it, we'll see later the sugya of Berachas Hareyach Hashem. You have to hold it in your right hand. Kishahu mevarech, when you say the bracha. And there are a number of discussions over here in the post about the way to hold it. And b'di'evid, it could be permitted if he's not holding it the way that the item should be held. Ein mevarchin lo al ichon v'le al mashka shviyuhu lefanav. You cannot say a bracha until the thing has been brought in front of you. Beirach v'achaka shviyuhu lefanav. If he said the bracha before the thing was brought in front of him, tzarich levarich pamacher, says to repeat the bracha. Avol misha beirach al peris shelefanav. If he made a bracha on a fruit that was in front of him. They brought him more of the same type of fruit. He made a bracha on an apple in front of him, they brought him another apple. Or a different fruit, he brought him an orange now. It's the same bracha. It's not have to repeat the bracha. And the Rama says, and the best thing to do is to have in mind that he'll say anything that he... anything that he is going to eat. That's the best kavanah you should have in mind originally. We got a discussion post about different scenarios, if it's in a container, if it's next to him, if he's thinking about it, not thinking about it, so on. Natal biyada piri l'eichlai, he took a fruit in his hand to eat it, v'rech l'av enafel miyada v'nevad, and it fell out of his hand and he lost it. A nimas is disgusting now. So he can't eat the fruit that he had in his hand when he made the bracha tzarchach. So Gavarech has to repeat the bracha when he eats the next fruit. Because I had a covenant to eat this apple, even though all the apples are on the table, he has to repeat it again with the next bracha. The Rama, however, says that this would only apply if he wasn't intending to eat that other fruit, but if he was intending to eat from whichever of the fruits, then he would still be yosi. There's a lot of discussion in the post on what to do with this type of scenario. In this case, when he has to repeat the bracha, he needs to say Baruch Shem Kved Malchusach Vod on the first bracha, because otherwise it would be considered like a bracha levatala. So by saying this nusach, that's mashma that he's giving kavod to the Shema Hashem, and by saying the Baruch Shem. V'im Amar Kishenafel Baruch At Hashem. If he had said Baruch At Hashem, then the fruit fell. V'lay Amar Elakenu. He didn't say yet the word Elakenu. Yisayim if Yomim Amdeinu Chukacha. Let him finish right now and saying Amdeinu Chukacha, which is a pasuk, and tell him she yehi nira kakere pasuk, ven kana mezi shem shemayim vatala. And then it doesn't look like he was being motzi shem shemayim vatala at all. There are poskim who talk about if you could even do this if you said more words than the bracha, if you said elikeinu, if you could finish with the pasuk that starts Hashem elikeinu, if you said elikei, you could finish with the pasuk as baruch ato Hashem elikei Yisrael, things around poskim like this. You could change it to be another bracha that wouldn't be a bracha vatala. A number of discussion poskim about the details of what to do in this case. However, if somebody is standing by a stream of an aqueduct, he can make a bracha and then drink. That the exact piece of water that was in front of him when he said the bracha is not the same drop of water he's going to drink, and when he finishes the bracha, it's flowing water. That was his kavana initially. Hagah. What to do if he made an incorrect bracha?